Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Wednesday Morning. It's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with today's look at Canadian stock market trends. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures on both sides of the border are below fair value, so we are looking for some selling at the open on Wednesday morning. Let's start off with a little housekeeping. Just a reminder, there will be no Protect Your Portfolio this weekend. I will be traveling. This will probably happen several times over the summer. We do plan to do a complete weekend update, which will be available to you on Saturday morning. Let's start off with a quick look at the U.S. market. And overall, confidence is very low right now. You can sum it up just by looking at the VIX. The VIX has not really moved that much since going on a sell signal. The sell signal itself, of course, is supportive for higher stock prices, but unfortunately, we cannot get a trend in the VIX. So there is certainly a divergence or discrepancy between how traders in Chicago, where they trade options, see the market, and traders in New York see the market. The stock index futures have been heading higher over the past week, but we can't get the VIX to move lower. So those traders are still holding on to their options, still hedging their bets, and not really excited about the future. And you can see that the pros, while they gave up control, which was enough to give us a sell signal, they look like they're coming back to take control. And we've had a bullish reversal day a couple of days ago. So the bottom looks like it's in for the VIX, and whether we turn around and go higher, that's yet to be determined. But it's certainly not the type of movement that you're looking for if you want the market to continue to move higher. Now, looking at the U.S. market, we'll use our Horizon Beta Pro ETFs, and we're currently long the S&P 500 Cash Index. Unfortunately, we've had two bearish reversal days in a row, and you can see when the pros took control here, but do they look like they're accumulating? Do they look like they're, hoping that this market continues to move higher? It doesn't look like that's what they're thinking at the moment. So yeah, they've been involved in this nice big rally that we've had, but they're not too excited about it moving higher from here. Now, for this particular ETF, we had a profit target of 56.25, so hopefully you locked in some money at that point, got some orders filled. I would certainly be interested in unloading some more of that today. You don't have to totally liquidate a position. We could certainly continue to move higher from here, but two bearish reversal days in a row, the VIX not moving in sync with the market is a concern. Now, the NASDAQ ETF, the 2X bull ETF, it's a bit more difficult to deal with since we actually had to gap higher to get a buy signal. Then we've been in this ETF for 2 days now, and it hasn't really moved much higher from here. You can see that the pros, while they're in control, they don't look like they're accumulating at the moment. 68.75 was our next target to the upside. You know, if you can get rid of some more today, that would probably be a good thing. You can see this peak from back in May. We have not been able to trade above that, so that's still acting as resistance. And then looking at the iShares or the Horizon Beta Pro 2X bull for the TSX, we've got really no movement here after generating a buy signal. And you can see the pros and the public are just moving in the same direction, and that is down at the moment. Yesterday was a bearish reversal day. 39.06 was our next target to the upside. And, I've always told you to round that down to 39. And we didn't even get close to that yesterday. We got as high as 38.83. So this is not looking good. Confidence is very low that we're going to be able to move higher from here. Next up, let's take a look at the Canadian market and what's working right now. Well, it's Infotech. The utilities are still in play. We had telecom come down to the lower channel line for the last 2 days. So potential sell signal there for telecom stocks. Materials have had a nice pop over the past 2 weeks. Global mining is up. And then we've got gold stocks, and certainly gold stocks easily broke out above the May high. Go back to the April high, we were able to trade above that, but then there was an open gap just above the April high. And so we filled that gap and pulled back. So we do have some gold stocks that are back on sell signals right now. So the weakest of the gold stocks are back on sell signals. Income Trust is on a buy signal right now. We're on a buy signal for capped REITs. Both of them pulled back in the channel yesterday. And similar situation for real estate. So we had a pop, and we're still holding buy signal, but it's looking rather weak at the moment. And then looking at the Venture Exchange, we actually made a new low, breaking through the May lows yesterday, and that is the risk-off trade. And so if people were enthusiastic about the market's prospects, you'd be looking at the Venture Exchange, the microcap stocks, also moving higher. That is usually often a leading indicator of what the market's intention is. And right now, people are taking risk off the table. So not very helpful for the bulls. Then energy stocks still on a sell signal. No change there. No change for preferred shares. They had a nice bounce over the past few days, but still not on a buy signal. Then looking at bank stocks, unable to get a buy signal so far for the equal weighted banking index. Healthcare is on a buy signal, but pulled back yesterday. Similar situation for the weed stocks. And then we've got financial services that made it back on a buy signal, but has not been able to move anywhere since then. Now, if we look at the TSX Most Actives, what I've done is just left last week's actives that were in place this time last week. I haven't changed the list, so if we just go through the list, there weren't a lot of trend changes over the last week. So Bombardier still on a buy signal, not going anywhere. And then we've got Aurora Cannabis still on a sell signal. That would change on Wednesday with a close above 1074. Then we've got Encana still on a sell signal. No change there. No change for Crescent Point. Then we've got GTE still on a sell signal. No change there. We've got Barrick still on a buy signal, while Yamana's pulled back and is now back on a sell signal. B2 Gold has pulled back in the channel and traded below the lower channel line yesterday. A close below 362 would give us a sell signal on Wednesday. Then we've got Enbridge continuing to move lower. Next target to the downside is 4531 and then 4375. We've got Kinross trading in the channel for the past 2 days. A close below $4.48 would give us a sell signal on Wednesday. Now the bearish reversal signal marked the top for this move so far. And of course that bearish reversal day, we penetrated the 488 level and then quickly reversed. And so hopefully you had orders in up at that level. You don't know how long it's going to last. As long as the market trades through that level, your sell order will be triggered and it will be filled at some price. In this particular case, you might have got filled at more than $4.88. Once it traded through it, it continued to trade above it. So you may have got filled above 488. Power still on a sell signal, no change there. Now, the first financial to show up in the most active list was Manulife, and it is still on a buy signal, but not going anywhere. And then we've got the first bank stock that showed up on the most active list last Wednesday was Bank of Nova Scotia, and it is still on a buy signal, no change in trend there. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation, and that's all for me for this week. Confidence is low. We've got a VIX that isn't trending. We've got venture stocks making lower lows. We've got bearish reversal days, lots of them on Tuesday, Monday and Tuesday. And so we're not looking for this market to be able to move much higher from here. Have a great day. And the next time you'll hear my voice is next Tuesday. And at that time, we'll take a closer look at the U.S. stock market.